show you that there is another meaning for the color red. Restoring everything damaged. God is going to restore everything damaged in your life. Hallelujah. Now, restoration. The definition of restoration is the action of returning something to a former owner, replace, or condition. It also means replacement or giving back of something lost or stolen or taken away.
Amen.
Other words to describe restored include repair, reclaim, mending, renewal, rebuilding, and redevelop. It's also known as cleaning. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Now, when you all own something that is precious to you and it breaks or gets dented or scratched, you know, you care about it enough and you love it enough to get it fixed, right?
Amen.
So, now some of us, we try to go and fix it on our own and end up making it worse. Now, when something is too damaged beyond repair, you need a professional, amen?
Amen.
Now, in some cases, that means body parts. A leg may be broken, an artery may need to be fixed. You know, an eye may need to be, you know, fixed or something like that. You need contacts, but you need a professional doctor, someone who is licensed, amen, to repair what has been damaged, amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. In the spiritual case, in situations that get us down, in situations that get us caught up and get us discouraged, we try to fix it on our own, but we end up making the situation worse by not just letting God do what he needs to do. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. We don't, when things happen in our life, and when we want something restored, we don't just want it back in any type of condition. Amen?
That's right.
Amen. We want it back better, in better condition than it was before.
Amen.
And that's what God is doing in this season. He's restoring everything damaged, but not just the way it was. He's making it better. He's perfecting it. Amen? Hallelujah. The definition of damage is to inflict physical harm on something so as to impair the value, its usefulness, or its normal function.
Uh-huh.
So let me break it down. Now, all of us have, I'm pretty sure, suffered a heartbreak in our life, whether it was a boyfriend or a girlfriend or, you know, something like that when we were younger. But someone, a woman or a man, who has been hurt multiple times, too many one-night stands, too many times that they've been cheated on, they start to feel like they're worthless.
Uh-huh.
Amen. They start to feel like they have no value. And so what happens if they get embittered? Amen.
Amen.
And what happens to their heart is their heart starts to harden, and now their heart is no longer useful to love. Amen.
Amen.
So now what happens is their normal function becomes unnormal. Amen?
Amen?
So what they resort to, okay, you know, I tried to love men, but that's not working, so let me go see, you know, I'll just see if a woman will love me better. Or, you know, I tried to love this woman, but, you know, women just don't work out for me, so I'm going to try my luck with men. So they resort to homosexuality and lesbianism. So now, the function that God intended, the way that God intended to function is no longer normal. Amen?
Amen.
And now they become abnormal.
All right.
Okay? You know, and when God was breaking this down to me, I was like, wow, God. I'm like, you know, I already know the enemy is going to be on my back. Because, you know, this right here is deep. And, you know, it took me all week to get this message. You know, I'm like, God, when are you going to give it to me? You know, my husband, like, hey, you got your message yet? I'm like, nope. You know, but I'm pretty sure God's going to give it to me in time. So, some of us have some things in our life that are damaged, you know, or was damaged, amen? But, you know, certain things in our life that are damaged or were damaged was families. Some of our families are damaged.
Yeah.
Marriages. Yeah. Relationships.
You're right.
Friendships.
Yes.
Our minds, our joy, our peace.
Amen.
Our emotions are so damaged due to situations that have occurred, and, you know, from people who we've allowed to come into our lives, and, you know, destroy and steal our joy, our strength, and our very relationship with God.
Amen.
We don't pray like we should.
Yes.
Fast. We don't pray, even come in and praise God like we should. But it's all about our flesh.
Amen.
Amen. If the praise team is up here and singing a song that you don't like, if it's set in the atmosphere, what should it matter?
Amen.
We are too many times when we come in here and we're in our flesh. If it sets the atmosphere, we should all be on one accord and let the praise team do their thing so that Bishop can come up here and not have to worry about setting the atmosphere herself. Amen?
Amen.
Our churches are damaged. Some people in the church are damaged by the church. Amen?
Amen.
But God is restoring the unity of the church.
Amen.
We all have become to get on one accord. We saw that tonight.
Yeah.
And now God's saying, okay, you know, my people have suffered enough. My people, I see they're trying. So let me give them a little push.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank
you.
So,
hallelujah.
Now I'm going to give you all an example. Job, which is the obvious example, but I'm going to go deeper into it. We know that Job lost the animals. He lost his sons and his daughters. You know, he lost his health. And then, you know, he cursed the day he was born. He didn't curse God, but he cursed the day he was born. He was upset.
Amen.
You know, his heart was damaged.
Amen.
In any situation, when you lose a child, when you lose everything that you have, your heart would be damaged too, God.
Amen.
You know, I don't understand why I'm going through this. What have I done? You know, I want to be in your favor. Have I lost favor with you? Have you forsaken me? I'm pretty sure these things were going through Job's head, but he never spoke it out. He never said, God, you know, just forget you. You know, I see you forgot me, so forget you. I'm just going to go out here and just die. You know? And then when we get in these situations, we always need to remember to keep our integrity. Amen?
Amen.
And one example I'm going to give is my mom. You know, she's been through a lot with her job loss. But one thing that she has never done that I've ever seen her do is lose her integrity as a woman of God.
Amen.
You know, when it seems like, okay, God, I don't know how I'm going to get through this. I don't know when the next paycheck coming. I don't know, you know, when this is coming, when that is coming. I don't know how we're going to eat, but I'm trusting you.
Amen.
And I'm trusting and believing that it's going to be over soon.
Amen.
And Mom, I just want you to know, tonight,